And that brings me to my final theory of Rochanomics, Rocha's economic theory. I advanced this theory to help for African development because I weep every day in my life knowing that my people are dead for lack of knowledge. Today, we are follow. Look at the computer now. You can never beat any master in his own game. For as long as Africa continues in this style, we shall remain a poor nation for history. There must be a reversal theory of power. We have ignored our culture. How can you beat an English person in English language? In fact, the best they can do for you is to applaud for you because you spoke well. But that does not mean that you're a master in that game. Africa has not changed. Listen. Thank you, students, children, thank you. Because what we go through to become a professor, other Western people don't go through to become a professor. First, they say you must pass English and pass mathematics before you can get a job. Who put that law? What does it represent? Tell me, what does that mean? Mathematics and English language as a prerequisite for admission is another form of neocolonialism. I thought you have said if you don't pass Igbo language. Do you know why mathematics is difficult? Mathematics is difficult because nobody has been able to explain it to me in Igbo language. If you ever explain 2x plus 3x is equals to 5 in the simple equation, nobody will beat me in this world. My problem is that I have to learn English language first before I understand the mathematics, before I begin to solve the question. So the world is tilted this way for Africans. And for every African to get, it's this way. So we are going from the bottom to the top, and people are already at the hilltop. And then they say, oh, your man's wrong. How can you run with a man who's already on the hilltop? Why don't you have a school here? Specific university for specific projects. Every year, 100,000 people come out, no job. That's why I quickly set up what is called Imo College of Advanced Professional Studies. It's doing well. Today, what I do there is, listen, you must be a graduate, you have no job, then come. We are doing what is called Oil and Gas Department, Underground Water Welding, NDT tests, computer, and all these specific things. So when I brought in Shell, I'm already preparing the thesis of Imo State for job. That's the kind of education we need now. So I suggest that after university degree, federal government should introduce institutions of professional studies. So after your degree, you can go and master in one small thing. So university must change their style to produce for us what our economy needs for development. That's why my Rochanomics operates in four principles, and I'll be fast. One is sacrifice. Rochanomics principles, one is sacrifice. For every leader to be a leader, he must have the mentality of sacrifice. When I came in as the governor, I gave up my 4 billion naira security fund. If you cannot make sacrifice, you have no business with leadership. Sacrifice means giving away those things that otherwise would have been so comfortable for you. So that the ordinary masses can have a reason to smile. The other part of it, and that's why I love Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that he gave his... Okay, the only English there that is very attractive to me is the word only. God gave crying. For I so loved you that I gave my only. Only means painfully giving. Our leaders must learn the art of painfully giving to the society. I bought all G's for my commissioners. Meanwhile, I've not bought any single car for myself as a governor. Sacrifice is the name of the game. The other point is culture. And quote me, this is my quote. Every society of mankind is created by God with their own culture and natural and material resources. For no nation or society can grow outside their culture and natural resources, for both has a relationship with God. Which has a culture. Our problem is today, you don't even know whether we are Americans. Look at the dressing here. Confusing. Some are Chinese here. Some are Americans. Some are Indians. Some are South Africans. Who are you? Your culture is the identity with which the whole world sees you. It's a mirror. How do the world see us? Do you know one time you call an American man and show him this house? He doesn't get impressed. But I wish you have designed this with Unko as a ceiling and some Oshishi as pillars. He said, wow, what technology is this? I've made this compulsory that anywhere I go abroad, I must speak Igbo language. So I went to Kosovo, invitation by the Deputy Prime Minister, and the man started and spoke his language, the interpreters. I said, Najula Mika, Chukwepo. Is that so? I told you, is that so? Nah, Kawara, I'm here. Deputy Prime Minister of Kosovo, Kangwaze Kikewe Zioku. Obodano. Dika, Okara Obodai. Baka, Mamu, Teja, put 2 million naira. I think Matthew Akwasi was with me, all of them were with me. Then the senator, Mr. Kowa, or maybe be before us, the excellency, the governor said, I should tell you. Okay. That's about the culture. We must go back to our culture and our language. The other one is political will. Leaders must have political will. You can never be a leader if you don't have a political will. Ability to say no when you ought to say yes. What if your wife comes to you, Vice Chancellor, and says, this is my in-law. Since you started Vice Chancellor, I don't benefit anything from you. She will say it one day. I've never seen the reason for this whole thing. Is it all that I paid for? And she said that because of her conviction. I said, I have this my brother here. He's the only last born of our sister. And he has 2 credits. And I want him to go to university. Can you at that point say, no, I will not do it. Because it's against the policy of the institution. Political will. Leaders who do not have political will cannot make success. The fourth one is what is called decentralization. Leaders decentralize. Ability to let people do your job and you take the credit for it. You know, the wisest, smart leader is the one that gets people to do the job and he sits on top and takes the credit. Do you know this government of Rocha is a corruption now? No matter what any commissioner does, it's me. The only way you can describe the attitude of a leader is lion. The greatest animal on earth is lion. And watch his style. When a lion finds his target, watch, it doesn't make noise. Leaders don't make noise. When he makes that sign, he has called all the small cubs. They all gather. Meanwhile, there's an elephant. You see how big an elephant is? As big as the nation's problem. But it takes a lion who is a leader to deal with that elephant. You must have an attitude of a lion if you want to be a leader. First of all, he sent that signal to frighten the huge elephant. You see, every leader must know how to package himself. If you don't package yourself, they will price you low. The difference between pure water and bottled water is packaging. when I came down there and I saw this man in suit, well dressed, I know that's the vice chancellor. But if I had seen somebody wearing jeans and this, maybe I would have passed him. So Lyons packaged himself well. He packaged himself well. First of all, he blows out that hair that makes it more frightening. You know what the lion does? Have you seen him fight? The head lion does not fight. Oh, he gives sign. This small, is it cock? Will fly on the elephant. This one will fly, this one will fly. They just catch the leg, catch the body, catch the tail. This one will fling it around. All of them will fly out again. They persist. They dance, don't quit. So, they keep talking. Before, this one will chop small leg. After a while, 2 hours, the big, huge elephant gets tired. You see it very down. And they will go. But when they get elephant down, the whole corpse again go back. Watch it, very interesting drama. The head, the leader goes back, to confirm that he's dead. But guess who goes to the war? It's a female cub. And he asks the big lion, why are you not fighting? He said, no, I'm sitting quiet to protect the future generation. God bless you.
It is a well-established fact that certainly the problem of Nigeria over the years had been a leadership problem. The Nigeria leadership challenge is certainly not insurmountable. With insight and knowledge-based information such as is espoused by Ewolere Chazukorocha, we can safely declare that the aspirations of our founding fathers will certainly come to pass. The problem with Nigeria is that Nigeria does not know its problems. Ewolere Chazukorocha.